Hi everyone, so in this video I'm doing an unboxing of a security camera made by Ring. It's called Ring Spotlight Cam Battery. So this security camera is actually battery powered. Now there's another model of the Spotlight Cam that's actually wired. The reason I got this one is because I also bought the solar charging kit for the Spotlight Cam battery, and because I'm gonna be mounting it at a weird area and I don't have easy access to any of the electricities available, so I'm using this combination. And of course, if your house have easy access wires, easy access sockets for the power, or if you can find an electrician to just come over and get the wiring done for you, you have the option to get the Spotlight Cam wired. From what I know, the wired, I think, have a slightly better video quality compared to the regular Spotlight Cam battery. But otherwise, all the features should be very similar. So let's go ahead and open up the box and take a look and see what's inside. And interestingly, my box came not sealed. Like, the box is kind of half open when I got the package, and I bought it brand new. So I'm not sure if you guys have the same problem or not when you get the package, because when I bought the Ring Doorbell 2 that I did a review previously, that box was sealed with a security seal tape. So that's kind of weird to me that this camera is not sealed, and it's just I can open the box without cutting anything. So over here you have the actual camera. It's very plasticky. I bought the white option, and I think those two areas are the LED lights that's supposed to be lighting up at night for better illumination, or when it actually detects motion. And let's see, and of course this is the sensor area for motion detection. Of course it uses infrared to detect any kind of motion over here. To take off the cover, I think you just press this little button and then the cover is off. So when the bottom is exposed, there are two batteries over here, two battery compartments. So supposedly it supports two batteries for longer operating time, and since I'm going to be connecting it to the solar panel, I'm only going to be using one battery, which is already included inside. Take it out. So on the bottom of the package, let's put this aside for a little bit. On the bottom of the package, there is your regular Ring sticker, security sticker, and of course the installation manuals is usually inside over here. And here's the security seal. Interestingly, they didn't even seal this thing, because this security seal is supposed to be at the packaging, and somehow they're just lying around here inside the installation kit, which is very weird. Here's your instructional manual, and there's a quick start. So basically it says download the Ring app. You set up the camera from your Ring app when you first time connecting it. So and the setup is very, very easy because I had the Ring Doorbell 2, and the configuration is super simple and easy. So we're gonna take a look at how the camera connects, but let's see. So what else we have? Of course, the standard orange colored USB charging cable for the battery. And hopefully the battery has some juice in it and I don't have to set it up and charge it. So we can go right ahead into the setup process. Of course, here are some anchors and screws. I think you need to use the anchor when you are drilling through a concrete hole, which I'm actually gonna do this time, because I'm mounting it on the side of my wall. And here are your two security screws. Now, I think there's only one security screw hole, so you have a backup security screw if the first one is lost. The other side, of course, a drill to drill through the wall. And this drill looks kind of cheap, So it's a cheap drill. I don't think it's gonna last, but I think if I'm only gonna be drilling the hole one time, it should work. Of course, your standard ring screw and multi-tool. So one side is regular Phillips and the other side is a security screw, kind of the tip. And it's, I think it's a small Torx tip, like very small Torx tip. Over here, this little white colored mount for mounting on the wall. Basically, what you're gonna do when you're actually mounting the camera is just go find a wall, find a good location. Before you mount it, of course, you position your camera on the wall and find a good spot. Once you find that spot, you're actually gonna mark your wall with some pencils and then just drill four holes below, under the mounting kit. And then, of course, put your camera onto here and then tighten this aluminum ring so nobody would be able to take this camera off from the wall. So it seems pretty simple. And I have to say, for all the ring devices, the installation is extremely simple. So I think a lot of people would be able to just do it by themselves, like instead of hiring people to actually install the camera for them. So let's just take a look. What's here? Okay, I'm gonna take a quick look at the manual and just see how to actually set up the device. I kind of already know, but just want to go through so you guys can take a look. So of course, you need to make sure the battery is charged and install the battery on the bottom of the camera, and then open up the Ring app, and then in the Ring app, I'm just adding a device in the Ring app. Of course, you need your Wi-Fi password beforehand so you can set it up very quick. So it looks like after you set up the Ring camera, you can already have the live feed over here, which is fantastic. And of course, the next step, it will be finding an area to mount on the wall. Mounting, of course. You need all the little kits that I just showed you. So right over here are all the basic kits. And depending on how you mount your camera, let's see. If you're mounting with this style of a mount on an Eve, you actually use the original setup like that. But if you're actually mounting it onto a wall, you have to take off this panel over here and then change the position of the little ball head. So I think I'm supposed to be pressing a button and then just removing that. You change the ball head into a different direction right over here and then just push it in. So you'll be mounting it like that on a wall. So the camera will be, yep, something like that. And if you're mounting it the other way, of course, you have the cover on the top, and then you have the thing over here. That's kind of how you mount it on the top. But of course, I'm showing you with the wrong side, but you get the idea. So depending on the mounting location, you need to change this little ball head. Okay, so next step, let's see, will be actually determining the correct height. So they recommended 9 feet off the ground for the motion detector to work, up to 30 feet. And that's a good starting point. My house is a two-story house, so I'm actually gonna be still be mounting it on the 9 foot height, 9 feet height. But I'll probably show you guys later on when I'm actually doing the actual installation. So installing the mounting bracket, of course, you mark it and then you just put the screw onto the wall, which is like fairly easy. There's nothing like complex about this little security camera, which is what I like. So of course, once you mount it, you can adjust the camera angle a little bit. And then after the setup, of course, you open up the Ring app and all those basic features. If you have another Ring device, all the features will be very similar, like in the Ring app. Motion detection setup, notifications, and all that kind of good stuff. Of course, there are Zoom setups. So for all the Ring devices that's battery powered, you don't get a nice like area, actual area preview. You only get a kind of approximate area preview, because it's using the infrared, it's for the motion detection, it's actually using the sensor up down here. But if you have a battery, if you have a wire powered device, you can actually preview the area, because I think it's using the actual sensor for the motion detection. Because you have constant power, you'll be able to, the camera will be able to use the sensor 24/7 to detect motion, and when it actually finds the motion, it starts recording. So that's one advantage, of course, also for the wired security camera from the Ring. So also looks like this camera supports the two-way talk, like the Ring doorbell, and when it actually finds the motion, it would start recording. And compare the Ring device to the Nest, I think the biggest downside, maybe like especially for me, but it might not be for everyone, is that it only records a limited amount of videos when it detects motion, and sometimes there is actual motion but it's not detecting the motion, so it will stop recording, which is something that I really don't like. Then like you will be missing out on a lot of video feeds that may be important to you. But of course, I think the recording plan is same with the Ring doorbell, which I think you pay $30, you get a whole year of service for the recording, and you can preview the recording for up to 60 days, I believe. Okay, so, and of course, there are some troubleshooting problems pertaining to, mostly probably going to be pertaining to battery, and then the Wi-Fi connection. So make sure the camera is fairly close to your router. If you have it far away from the router, you might have some bad quality signals. Okay, so we just went through the manual, and I'm actually gonna set it up right over here, and then we're actually gonna take a look at the solar panel in a little bit. Just one thing to note is that the solar panel connects to the little power connection hole right over here. So, which is good. Now sometimes the hole is covered with this little white cover. Just remove the cover and move it to the other side. Okay. Let me install the battery, and I'm gonna grab my phone, and we're gonna connect the camera and take a look. Okay. So let's open up the Ring app. I have my phone right over here. So gonna go to the Ring app. So, and this is my first time setting up the camera, so even though I already set up the Ring doorbell, I kind of know what to expect, but there might be some unfamiliar features while I'm setting up this device. So of course I have the Ring app right over here. Basically I'm gonna put the battery in. I think any side works. So, and I'm gonna close the cover. See, there's a little light that lights up inside. Oh, there's the light over here as well. Interesting. And this bottom cover is kind of cheaply made. It doesn't fit in very snugly. Just a heads up. So right now it's flashing, so I think it's in pairing mode. So I'm gonna go ahead and set up the device. Of course, super easy. It just tells me I want to set up a security camera. I need to scan the code. I think the code is somewhere down inside the camera right here. So I'm gonna scan the code really quick. Let's see. All right, so it already find my things. Interestingly, it also asked me to set up the solar panel. So let's see. I'm gonna set it on the side. So setting up the battery, there's my address, I'm going to block it out. So next, so this is going to be in my front yard. Let's see what custom does. Yeah, I'm just going to use front. So insert the battery, wait 30 seconds. Yeah, it's already powered on, so I'm going to continue and press the button on top of the spotlight cam. And as you can see, the setup is extremely simple, and they have a video setup right over there. So that is fantastic. So I'm gonna press the button. And of course, the little setup thing lights up, and I'm gonna continue.
Okay, so it's joining the Ring Setup Network. So it's gonna be pairing the device, which is cool. All right, so it looks like it's gonna search for the nearby Wi-Fi password. And if you have already set up your Ring doorbell before, it already saved your Wi-Fi network, which is great. I'm just gonna hit connect. So it connects to my existing Wi-Fi network. And that is awesome. Like, setup is super simple. It's already done. Oh, wow. Okay, so it says front is updating. That means the camera is updating the firmware for the first time. So I'm gonna click continue. And I'm gonna skip the shared user setup. Basically, you can use different emails to log in to the cell phone if you have multiple, you know, users. But I just use the same setup for everybody in the family, so it doesn't really pertain to my needs. Ready to install the camera now. Okay, so now the camera is already fully set up. The next step would just be for me to actually install it onto the wall and find a good location. So before we do that, we're gonna do an unboxing of the solar panel and see what's going on before I go ahead and start installing the camera on the wall. So I'm gonna skip. But if you don't skip the physical install, they provide a very easy to follow. They set up a very like simple, easy to follow video, so you can set it up fairly quick. And I don't even think I'm gonna show you guys the installation, because just follow this and it should work fairly good. Basically, I'm just going to be drilling four holes on the wall and then put it up there, and also, of course, drilling some holes for the solar panel and finding a good location where there's a lot of sun to have the solar panel installed. So let's see. So it's pretty self-explanatory in the setup. So I'm gonna skip the installation video, hopefully, and I don't want to bore you guys. And let's actually just check out the camera first. So skip the step, skip, and see, as I discussed before, your motion detection is gonna be just a simple, unfortunately, it's a simple like graphic area preview. And you have the option to turn on and turn off the lights when it actually detects motion. For now, I'm gonna turn it on, just see how it works at night. And of course, I'm gonna want it to detect motion from really far away as well. Because the whole reason I got all the Ring set up, Ring devices, is because my car was opened by someone a few weeks ago and they took some of my belongings in my car. And it's on my side, it's bad because I forgot to lock my car that time. And but then I still feel the need to actually have a video camera just in case if someone comes again and I'll be able to record something, okay? So of course, I'm gonna set up to the maximum motion zoom and hit continue. So it's already set up, super simple. Like, here's my front door right over here. I can preview my front door stuff by using the live view. So you're gonna open up the, you know, live view in my front door, which is right over here. I think my phone's this way, yep. So there's my front door, and I can talk, two-way talk, and I can just end it right now. So we can go back to the actual thing that I'm gonna be doing unboxing today, So which is the front camera. So I'm gonna go over here, check the battery. So the battery is pretty much charged. I can add a battery by buying a few extra batteries, which is nice, but let's see. But we're not gonna do that because I'm gonna be using the solar panel. So of course, over here it gives you a whole bunch of information pertaining to your device and the health. Of course, I'm gonna be blocking this page out since it has some sensitive information. Let's see, event history, that's to check if there's any motion. So it already said it detected the motion. Let's see, what it recorded. If someone comes again, I'll be able to record something. Okay, interesting. It already starts to detect emotions. Okay, so let's refresh. Let's see. So let's use the live view and see how the video quality is. And as you can see, this is inside my house. The feed is very good. It's a very wide angle view. So if you want something centered, if you want the best results, make sure you point the center area to the most important part of your monitoring area. So for example, like if I'm pointing over there, probably the chair is the area that I want to focus on. So don't put the important area to the edge, because everything's gonna be distorted and it's not gonna be good. So set it up over here, and it have two-way audio. I don't want to try, because if I click here, it's gonna have crazy echoes, you know. But in terms of like preview, it works just fine. And you can see kind of the delay there is, because of course the feed have to go to the server and then come back to my phone. So I'm gonna hit end. Excuse me. So there's a live view. Of course, you can also link the chimes, like the doorbell, to boost your signal, and also I guess have some sort of alarm sound when there's motion detected. So there's motion snooze. You can snooze it for a few amounts of time if you don't want to feed, you know, when you are doing something in your front yard. And the motion setting. Excuse me. I'm gonna put it down. Motion setting, of course, this is a Zoom setup that we just did. And of course, the schedule is for it to disable the motion. For example, if you're coming home, you know, there's a certain time you're coming home, you don't want the alarm to sound, just disable it at a certain time. Smart alerts control how often you want to receive the alerts. I would assume if you use frequent, it's more sensitive in detecting motions. But I find on my Ring doorbell, the standard works just fine. So unless something changes, I'm just gonna set it to standard. But if you want a lot of motion alerts, you can definitely use frequent, you know, over there. App alert tone, that's where you change the ringtones. So basically if it detects a motion, I think the wind chime works great. I love this sound when actually someone's you know, when there's motion, like even at work, it chimes and nobody is gonna know, you know, this is your Ring doorbell, unless someone have the same Ring doorbell. But it sounds like very pleasant, and it's very it's also very noticeable. So I like this default alarm tone, which is great. Live view settings, I think you only have the option to turn it on and off. And shared users is where you add, you know, extra users. But it's already detecting motion. I think it actually saw my cats over there. So let's see if it actually detected my cat moving around. So, yep. So it actually found my cats, and then it's telling me, hey, there's a cat. So it works pretty decent. Of course, if this is mounted high, a cat walks by, it's not gonna detect it. This is only because, you know, it's really close. It thinks that the cat was a person, which is funny. So over here, let's see. So there is pretty much it. The Ring actually, the Ring device is very, very simple to use and set up. It's nothing complex. So we're gonna finish with this part, and let's just take a quick look at the actual solar panel and see what it looks like. Hello, Sesame. So there's my cat Sesame. And first open it up. All the Ring package is very similar. This is the installation instruction manual right over here. So same thing, drill two holes. And mount the solar panel onto the thing, onto the wall. And then the last step is connecting the power over there, and then use the screw to secure it onto the actual camera. And this is one thing I forgot to tell you. I think this is like an additional instructional manual. It says, and we only realized after printing, we messed some important information. So basically it asks you to remove the cover if you have the cover, you know, right over there that haven't been removed. But for my setup, it works fine. But if you have the actual ball head on the top, you need to remove this cover to expose the battery connection right over there. Okay, so don't forget that. And of course, here's the actual solar panel. Seems pretty well made. The panel itself, this is actually glass. The whole panel is glass. Of course, there are solar kits inside. And this is, I think, a fairly long wire. Let's see how long it is. And of course, inside, very similar things. Very consistent for the ring, which I like. Exact same tool right over here. Now I already have three of those tools and three of the drills. I don't need any more. Anchor kit, which is exactly same over here as well. So you have a lot of extra screws to mount the thing onto the wall, which is nice. And this is a little plastic actual holder right over here. So basically, I'm gonna be like, let's see. So I can put it in here, and then it locks, it actually locks into place. There's a little clip over there. And it only goes in one way. On this side, it doesn't go in. So make sure you mount it correctly. And there's an arrow telling you, you know, where to put it in, which is good. Over here is a little battery connection. I have two little security screws. And over here is the actual, I think instead of mounting it on the bottom, I'm gonna mount it on the top. So basically you do that, put it in, and then you screw it in, so it's connected, which is also super simple. Now the only thing we don't know is the performance of the solar panel, how well it charges. Hopefully it charges well, then I don't have to worry about charging the battery. By going up to the wall, take off, you know, the bottom cover, and then replace the battery, which is gonna be a huge hassle. Let's see. So this wire is also super long. I think it's at least 5 meters. Not 5 meter. It's fairly short, unfortunately. So this is probably like 1 foot, 2, 3, 5 foot, not 5 meters. And I would assume that is the length, which is I think, let's see, divide by 3, that's a little, sorry, let's see, well, I would say it's long enough. My table is like 48 inch each side, so it covers it for like 2 loops at least. So that gives you sort of an idea how long the wire is. I'm gonna put a text into the video of the actual length of the wire, but for now it seems like I have a fairly good amount of freedom to mount this like far away from the camera where there is a good spot for the sun. And again, that I might show you guys a video when I actually finish installation and see where the solar panel is set up and where the camera is, and then show you guys some more live feed of the camera actually on the wall. But for now, this setup is complete, so let's move on to the next step. Okay, just want to show you guys to drill the hole on the wall. I'm simply going to be using a battery powered Bosch hammer drill. Of course it works as a regular drill, but this drill works exceptionally well. I have lots of torque, and it's easy to penetrate like masonry and concrete walls, because the hammer action is actually what breaks up, you know, the wall to actually get the drill bit to going deeper. So I'm going to be using, of course, the hammer drill mode. If you have a regular drill, it should work okay, but it takes slightly longer to actually drill through any kind of like stone and concrete walls. So this is what I'm going to be using, and of course I'm going to be using the included tip right over here.
over here. I'm gonna have my little mounting screws ready for a drill. Once I have a good location spotted, I'm gonna be drilling through. I know I said I'm not gonna show you guys how to mount it on a wall, but I think it's important to get a whole picture when you're actually installing the security camera so you know exactly what to expect. Okay, so this is the kit I'm gonna be using to drill the wall. And of course you need the little pencil to mark up the little holes over here, you know, when you actually find a good location. But something extra to keep in mind. So as you can see, I actually already marked four holes that I'm going to be drilling, and the drill bit I'm using is the one that's provided. And this is a stone wall, so I'm going to be using the anchor. That's why I'm drilling through the four hole marked. So I'm going to go ahead and start drilling the hole. So as you can see, I have two holes drilled and it's deep enough to fit one of those anchors. So I am just gonna install the two anchors first. Put it in there. Use a little hammer to knock it in. And of course, the other one. And I'm pretty sure three anchors is enough to hold it very steady on the wall. So I'm only gonna drill three holes instead of four. And I'm actually gonna drill a hole, I think right over here, to just mount the camera on there. You know what, let's drill a hole, let's drill four since it's like really easy, so never mind. Alright, so I got all four holes drilled, and next step is just gonna go ahead and install the mounting bracket, and then of course final step is install the camera. Now I still need to figure out where exactly to put my solar kit, because as you can see, my house on this side is facing north. I don't have any sun exposure. So I may have to go all the way up to the top and mount it somewhere close to the roof. But that's gonna be our next video, how the solar panel is installed. Now, interestingly, when I put the bracket on, I realized, you know, I didn't align the holes very perfect. I didn't align the holes perfectly, so they're a little misaligned. And hopefully when I screw it in, the little bracket would stay in place. I think at least I have three screws that can be securely mounted. So we'll see how it goes. It kind of fits. So despite being misaligned a little bit, it still kind of fits. Now as you can see, the little rubber that's supposed to be a seal kind of on the screw all popped out, but I guess that shouldn't matter much since this mount is very securely mounted right now. Next step, I'm gonna put the camera on and see how it goes. So camera's right over here. And at this point, I'm not gonna mount the solar kit. As I said before, I need to find a good location for the solar. Right now I'm just gonna use the battery and test and see how long the battery would last. And again, make sure before you actually permanently mount, screw the security screw in so it can be mounted, it can be secure and nobody is able to actually remove your battery from the camera or store your battery. So right here. And it's clicked in, and the next step, of course, I need to actually
tighten the little ring over there, so it doesn't move around.